I have written a letter already to Mr. Sarath Veerasekara about 2 weeks ago, because we have felt that the investigations into the Easter Sunday attack are not going on with a sense of determination to find who is responsible. In fact, the former Attorney General made a statement to say that there was a grand conspiracy, but he never specified what that grand conspiracy was. So there are certain elements in this Easter Sunday attack which have not been investigated thoroughly. There are some aspects of the extremist movements in Sri Lanka which have not been investigated thoroughly. Insinuations coming that some politicians have been involved in this plot, but no investigations have happened. Then there are some statements that have been made in the commission which were not seriously investigated. There was this case of that witness Jamil, one who exploded the bomb, the last one, that he had met an army person called Sonic. That matter has come up, but no one has investigated. Not even the commission has thoroughly investigated who this person was who had a contact with Jamil and why. This was mentioned in Parliament by Mr. Harin Fernando and some others. This should have been investigated, but it has not been investigated. Similarly, there is that story of role played by Sarah Jasmine. We don't know where she is. Earlier, the investigations into the body parts found in Batiklo after the explosions and the attacks and the firing, they said that Sarah Jasmine's DNA was not found there. Therefore, she was not there. So where is she? Investigations have not been conducted on that. Now they are trying to claim that they have dug back all those body parts and investigating again in order to somehow prove that she was among the dead, which is an unrealistic position. But no investigations have been conducted. The CID not investigating in the way they should. I went to courts to ask for a writ of mandamus in order to get the swords investigate. The minister informed the IGP informed the courts that they have appointed 2 CID teams, but we don't even know what has happened to the CID teams, because the CID teams are working according to political agendas. Therefore, we don't have trust in those CID teams also. We don't have trust in the IGP also, because there are certain points that have emerged in the commission report which require IGP's attention. He has not done anything on those matters. Then the Attorney General should have prosecuted the former president and some of the leading officers in the police responsible that time, who could have prevented this bloodbath and massacre, but who didn't do anything, who ignored it, who cast cold water on it. But no investigation has happened. No allegations have been, or accusations have been brought forward to the courts, which is the recommendation of the commission. And this famous 6-member committee of ministers, this is a tomfoolery by the president to try to choose against whom action should be taken and against whom action should not be taken. Therefore, there are 2 laws in the country. One law for those powerful figures and one law for the others. So all this is a very non-transparent attitude that is going on in the country, and we are very sad about the present situation. We are left with no other option but to carry on with our campaigns against the present government for its neglect of duty on this matter, because I was given a promise by the president that he will give top priority to this security issue, but he has not done that. We are not satisfied about what has happened. And secondly, we will have to go to the international fora in order to have a thorough investigation into this famous grand conspiracy about which the former IGP spoke. We want to know what that grand conspiracy is. As you know, the Catholic Church is an international body, so we have our connections all over. So it is possible for us to do something about it through our network of connections with the other countries. And also we are able to approach some of the United Nations organizations directly in order to find solace for our people. Because 269 people men, women and children who had nothing to do with Islam or Islamic extremism or anything to do with, we never had anything against the Muslims. In fact, we protected all the Muslims after the attacks from any attacks against them. We will continue to do that because we respect the Muslims very much. But it's not against the Muslims, it is against extremism. Therefore, we will have to ask for a transparent investigation into what happened and why these people were killed and these people were maimed and made disabled for life. For what reason? I have not mentioned all of this in the letter. In a letter, I have mentioned only that we want justice done and speedy action on some of the proposals of the Presidential Commission report, where it has mentioned very clearly this one has to be prosecuted under certain sections of the penal code, this one has to be prosecuted, the other one has to be prosecuted. These are mentioned for about 9 or 10 people.
News Hub, peopleizing the news.